Everyone, welcome back. Previous video, we were setting up our host game setup menu. So we got that up and running, and we also did the graph, which is actually what we did in the previous video. The video before that, we did the design layout. But our graph is set up for play. Quick recap, we can host, select host game, we can enter a name, hit accept, we can change the number of players, etc. So that's what we've done so far. Up next, we're going to do our options menu. We'll probably do the design portion and then the pause, and then we'll pick it up and do the graph in the next video. So for this, what we'll do is similar to what we did before. I'm going to open up the host menu, and I'm going to go to open up the options menu now. And let me dock this up here. So on the host menu, take the border, just copy that, because we're going to use a lot of the stuff that's in here already. So our host menu is copied. We're going to go to options. We're going to paste it now. Expand this all out a little bit. And let's move this over to the center. It's already anchored to the center. It's fine. Let's change the text at the top. This is now player options. So we could say options or settings or whatever you want. I'm just going to call it player options. Like so. And reselect the border and just something like that. Looks good to me. Now, we're not going to have entering a server name or anything like that, but we are going to allow the players to enter their own name. So let's go ahead and change this here from enter a server name to enter your name. Now, I wanted to use Steam names here. However, there's no blueprint. There's no way to access that through blueprint. And I don't think there's a way to do it. Well, there is a way to do it, but I'm not quite sure how to do it in C++. When I spoke with the team here about that, they didn't have an answer for me on how you could do that in C++ off the top of their head. But it is possible if you want to do it through the code side. I'd have to dig into that a little bit more to see how you could do that. From the blueprint side, hopefully we can get that exposed down the road. But for now, we're just going to allow people to enter their own names. Kind of the old school way of doing things, but should be fine. So with that, enter a name. I think this is good. We don't need this, and we don't need the option below it. So let's take our enter name here, and let's delete this. And let's take our horizontal box and delete that. And what we're going to have here is the ability to choose an avatar. Again, this is something that's not exposed through blueprints, getting this Steam avatar. Not quite sure how to do that through blueprint, so we're mostly focused on the connection is what we're trying to do here. So the Steam overlay and friends list and all that is there. Pulling that type of information may be something that we'll have to tackle in a future video. At that point in time, maybe we can also do pulling your Steam name. So let's go ahead and change this to select avatar. So, and it's not going to be text in here, so I'm going to delete this. It's actually going to be an image. So let's take image, drag and drop that in between. So, and this image, we're going to wrap that with a size box. So right click and wrap with size box. We can then select the size box and override the width and height. We could say 256 by 256, something like that. So that'll be the avatar image. OK, let's compile and save. There's one other thing that we want to do here. We're going to add some text outside of this vertical box. So let's go here. Let's see. It's actually going to be outside of the border, too. So we're just going to take some text and throw it down, something like this up top. Gonna stretch it out, something like this. And we'll anchor it to the center top, like so. The text itself, let's change the font size up to this. Let's say 50, 48 maybe. I'm just winging it. 48. Let's change the font size or font type to not Roboto. We want to change it to light, actually. I don't have any fonts here, so we're just going to change it to light, something like that. What we want this text to say is, please set up your player profile to continue. Then we could size to content, this option here. And this text, what we're going to do for this text, let's see. What this will be used for is we don't want the player to be able to, let's compile and save, arrive at the main menu, go directly into find a match without setting up their options and their player name and avatar. So if you haven't set that stuff up before, what will happen is it'll before you get to the main menu, you'll see this, please set up your player profile to continue. And then once you set this, you'll never see it again unless you delete your save file. But we just don't want the player to not have a username or avatar at all before they go into a match. It's typically how games handle this. They have you set this up front and then take you to the main menu. So that's how we're going to do it. So that's actually going to do it for this video. This video is going to be very short. We're going to pick it up in the next video where we start working on the graph. Thank you guys for watching, and we'll pick it back up then.